Hey guys, Matt Gao here, and today I want to talk about one of the most recent controversial topics, which is the whole Google Manifesto thing. And there are some aspects of it that scare me quite a bit. Now, if you haven't read the whole thing, you can check out the link below. And it's just 10 pages, it's not very hard to read, so you should be able to do it in just a few minutes. But regardless, the gist of it is that a guy at Google sent an internal memo, it seems, talking about how he feels like the diversity programs are actually discriminating, are being discriminatory themselves, but that's besides the point. Basically, if you read the 10 pages, I believe he tries to be as impartial as he can, explaining his rationale and trying to explain why he thinks that way. And I also believe that his main point is that we shouldn't force diversity just for the sake of diversity. And it has basically blown up, and it has blown up everywhere. But regardless, he got fired for the memo, and when I look it up online, I usually see two types of reactions to this. On the one hand, there are people who are a bit outraged and confused as to why he got fired, because pretty much he was saying how people are afraid of sharing their opinions if they're unpopular, and Google kind of proved the point, I think, by firing him after I believe he tried to start a conversation about this and tried to fix the issues, and he actually proposed some solutions if you actually read the whole thing. But, and here's what I believe is the scary part, on the other hand, the other type of people are those who are cheering that he got fired. And the thing that confuses me the most is that all of them just keep calling him sexist. And basically, whenever I see someone making tweets or videos about him, I always see that they make up interpretations for what he said. Basically said that women and men, on average, have certain characteristics, which I believe nobody can really disagree on that. It's not just a social thing, but for example, I never really cared what other people thought of me. I mean, I would run silly ways back and forth in school or do random shit and everybody would mock me, but I wouldn't care. And still, I still feel drawn out to many things that are usually more male-oriented, such as, I don't know, programming, more recently cars and things like that. And on the other hand, my girlfriend also usually leans a bit more towards girl stuff, so... But that's besides the point. The thing here is that I believe he tried so hard to explain his point of view. He even provided sources in most of the things he said, and yet people are just completely disregarding that and labeling him all kinds of insults to try and harm his credibility and also get support from those who are seeing them, and that's what scares me. I even saw a video, I think it was from Pop Trigger, my girlfriend was watching it, and they were basically just bashing him, calling him sexist and whatnot. In one particular moment, one of them said one very interesting thing, which was that, oh, imagine if people said that white people are better than black people for certain jobs. And the funny thing is, I don't think he realized it, but in my opinion, I believe that already exists. And that is sports. I mean, I'm not a sports person myself, but at least from what I've seen, it seems like most professional athletes in like soccer teams or the Olympics and things like that, most of them are black people, because I believe that on average, they tend to be physically better. They either have more stamina or... I don't know, I never studied these things, but I mean, that seems to be the case. And I don't think it is so bad to point that out, because it's a fact. And on the other hand, he said that women tend to lean more towards people, while men usually tend to lean more to things, and I believe that's also true. I've seen that with pretty much every person I knew. When I was in high school, most of my female classmates, many of them had interested in going like to kindergarten, or being a primary school teacher or something like that, while the guys usually, you know, were a bit more into sports, they were a bit more into tech and things like that, and there's nothing wrong with either of them. And there's nothing wrong with that either, and I believe what James Damore was trying to say is that since women on average tend to like certain things and men tend to like other things, I believe what he meant is that we shouldn't force or we shouldn't change the rules so that one or the other gets more representation in certain areas, but rather adapt those areas to appeal to those tastes. What scared me is that even though he explained everything as logically as he could to try and fix this and make everyone better instead of discriminating just to create that equality in percentages, that everyone still ganged up on him, and it seems like nobody actually read anything that he said. I mean, he never said that men or women are better at anything, just that on average they tend to lean towards certain areas or others. And on the, I believe it's on the second page, he actually says there's an overlap between them, so there's no individual differences. And yet, everyone that is against him is always saying, oh, he said that men are better. And he never did. He merely said that men tend to have a higher tendency to get interested in that job than women. And on the other hand, women tend to prefer other kind of things. And if that's the case, I don't see what's wrong with that. I mean, I don't see what's wrong with me liking things that are typically male just because I'm a male. I mean, if I like things that are female, I wouldn't have a problem with that, but I understand that I would be in the minority. But I don't know. What do you guys think? What do you guys think about this? Do you think that he said anything that he shouldn't? Do you agree with what he said? I don't know. I want to see your comments below, see what's going on, because this whole thing is just blowing my mind, and I have no idea why it's so hard for people to be on the same page. But yeah, have a nice day, everybody. I'm Ed Cal. These are my pups. And that's about it. Bye-bye.